Well, there's new hope of a travel bubble between Australia and New Zealand, with suggestions flights between New South Wales and its eastern neighbour could take off within weeks. New Zealand's Deputy Prime Minister Winston Peters joins me now. Kia ora, Winston. Is this really going to happen?
Well, we've never given up hope on the bubble plan. We've worked on it very staunchly for a long time, and the real issue is whether or not we can ensure that the protocols work for both countries.
What needs to happen on both sides of the Tasman, then, for the flight path to open up?
Well, Prime Minister Morrison mentioned a very interesting concept about the trouble spots and the different hot spots that we might have to more focus on rather than close the whole state down or the whole city down. And I think, personally, he's right. We need to look very seriously at that concept, because in many ways, apart from the end of the Auckland spike we've had, we're to go. And the sooner we get going, then the better. Personally, if we can ensure that both in Australia and New Zealand we're safe in what we seek to do, it's very important that we get our tourism back on track as fast as we possibly can.
100%. I mean, operators on both sides of the Tasman are really struggling right now, and we need to try and help them out and also, well, help each other out. It's expected New Zealanders will be able to fly into New South Wales without quarantining before we can head over there. Is that about accurate?
Well, that's what I'm hearing is being offered out of New South Wales. And, of course, you've got Tasmania with an excellent record. So has Queensland. But it's over to the authorities to ensure that it happens both ways. Mm. Otherwise, you'll drain us of our wealth with no commensurate repay on the other way back.
We wouldn't want to do that. any indication? I mean, how advanced, Winston, are the talks? I mean, you and I have been talking about this for months and months and months. How advanced are the talks between yourself and the states, and also from a federal point of view?
We started these talks in our two foreign affairs departments in New Zealand and Australia 2 days before we went into the first lockdown a long, long time ago. And so how advanced? I think the talks are not the problem. It's the empirical evidence about the danger that has been the sort of handicap when you think about how cautious we've tried to be, given the disappointment of the Melbourne experience in particular,
yeah,
and a second breakout here in Auckland.
Do you think it's likely to happen before Christmas, realistically?
Personally, I think it's capable of happening much, much sooner than that, and I hope so. The real issue is systems are important, and the oversight of systems is so critical now. But if we've got the safe travel and the tracing operations running as they should at 100%, then I think it can be much, much sooner.
And the good news is, I noticed with interest in the last couple of weeks that you're opening things up for our wallabies to come into New Zealand and towel up the Kiwis. That's good news.
Well, you might say that's a slight contradiction in a sense, because whilst we've been doing things with respect to the general population, you've got that decision. Mm. But we've probably got a long way to go on those negotiations as well. Yeah. We don't quite know at this point whether it's going to come off or not.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
we'd love to see you guys. I mean, you've got a New Zealand coach. You've got a New Zealand coach, so that means you've got a chance.
Well, thank you for that. Let's hope that does happen, and hopefully the borders will come down. And I know you've got a big election coming up too. How are you placed? How are you looking?
Oh, well, New Zealand is no different from... Well, the dog's barking in a claim, so to speak. But the reality is that you've got the polls in New Zealand. They're very similar to the polls in Australia, as they were in the United States and as they were in the Brexit campaign of 2016. So what we've got difficulty is the total abeyance to polls, which these days are so methodically specious,
yeah,
and uncertain. Nobody thought, for example, that when we went into the Australian campaign, the outcome would be that. But anybody that suspected the polls thought this could happen in Australia.
Mm. I somehow think you're going to be all right. Good on you, Winston. Thanks so much for your time today. Always appreciate it.